Hello, chess friends, and welcome to the channel. Today is day 2 of the Clutch International 2020. The tournament is an 8 players knockout with the Clutch system. With 8 players, we begin from the quarterfinals, and these players will play 12 games to win the match. But we already know that games 5 and 6, also game 11 and 12, are the most important ones because they are the Clutch games, and the winner gets 3 points instead of 1. The matches in play today are Dominguez Perez versus Caruana and Grischuk versus Aronian. We will begin with Dominguez Perez Caruana game 1. Let's get started, because even if this is not a clutch game, I would like to show you, because really it's a fun attacking game. Dominguez Perez with the white pieces, Caruana with black. Let's get started. So Dominguez Perez opens with e4, Caruana answers with c6, the Caro-Kann. d4, d5, and here comes e5. This is the advanced variation. Bishop to f5 out of the pawn chain. Here comes h4, so that black can't play e6, or g4 is coming, and this poor bishop is in danger. So h5 creates a way out for the bishop, and here comes bishop to d3. Bishop captures, queen captures, black can play e6. I open the database and I noticed that Dominguez Perez never played this position, but Caruana already played the same position against the Italian Grandmaster Vocaturo in 2017, and the game ended in a long draw. Dominguez Perez immediately deviates from that game, where Vocaturo played the main continuation, that is bishop to g5. Instead, here comes knight to f3. Now bishop to e7, bishop to g5 is still the most played move. But Dominguez Perez continues with almost a novelty, but a very good move, that is the immediate c4. Of course, this push is a thematic move in the advanced variation, but I have only one game in database where c4 is played in this position, and not between grandmasters or even international masters, so we can consider this move almost a novelty. After c4, there is d captures on c4. The queen recaptures, knight to d7, the game is now completely original, because in the game that I have in database, another good move was played, and the move is knight to h6. After knight to d7, here comes queen to c2, because probably Dominguez Perez doesn't like to allow this knight to b6 with tempo. This is a good idea, but also knight to c3 was another good idea. With queen back to b3, white neglects this knight to c3, more or less. Both lines are good. But here comes c5, and c5 is not a mistake at all, but is a risky move, because we already saw it many times that opening the lines with the king still in the center of the board, it's a risk. Now, what happens? It happens that the most common continuation would be to capture. Let's watch what happens if white capture with the d-pawn on c5, not played by Dominguez Perez. Then the knight will recapture, knight to c3, rook to c8, also watching the queen. Short castle, best idea, queen to d3, and black will force a queen's exchange with white, that has a small advantage. But of course, the game is completely open, but Dominguez Perez is not interested in this position and in this small advantage. After c5, he doesn't capture, but continues with d5, that is a pawn sacrifice. Now, of course, black must accept this pawn, or this capture will completely mess up the pawn structure. So he captures on d5, and now a second pawn sacrifice to expose the king, and again black is forced to accept the pawn. F captures on e6, and now queen to g6 comes with check, and of course is also a fork. King to f8, a game like this won't end in a draw. Queen captures on e6, regains one pawn, and now bishop to f6. Short castle for white, knight to e7 is protecting d5, because the queen was also attacking d5. But here comes knight to c3, and the pawn is 2 times under attack. Now, what happens? Caruana continues with one of the best ideas. I don't know if this rook to c8 that Caruana played is the best move because the computer likes much more queen to c8, but the idea behind the move is good because black is already a pawn up, so losing this pawn is not his main concern. The great problem is to activate this rook and to bring the king to safety, because in this position, if you play d4 not played by Caruana, this move doesn't work because now there is the simple knight to e4. Then rook to e1 is coming and there is too much pressure, it's impossible to hold the position. So after knight to c3, Caruana leaves the pawn to his fate and continues with rook to c8. The idea is to give back the pawn but to stabilize the position. What happens now? It happens that knight captures on d5, not played by Dominguez Perez, will only give white a small advantage because here comes knight captures on d5, the queen recaptures, knight to e5, attacking with the discovered attack against the queen and also this attack that will mess up the pawn structure. So queen to b3, best idea. There is still some advantage for white, mostly because the king is still exposed, but more or less black was able to improve his position. Let's go back to our rook to c8. There is another idea that probably is winning in this position, and this idea is knight to b5 with the terrible jump, knight to d6 that comes with tempo because will threat checkmate and also is attacking the rook, so probably winning this exchange, and probably this knight jump is already winning the game. Instead, after rook to c8, Dominguez Perez continues with another strong idea that is knight to g5, threatening checkmate in one. The bishop is forced to capture, bishop captures, bishop recapture is a good idea. Now the knight is also pinned. There is also this idea of knight capture on d5. So here comes rook to c6, attacking the queen. Bishop captures with check, the queen recaptures, and now finally the queen captures on d5. And regains the second pawn, but with advantage because again the king is exposed and this rook seems difficult to activate. Now it seems to me that the best way to activate the rook is rook to h6. Instead here comes knight to f5 played by Caruana, that is an okay move, and now queen to f3 pinning the knight, king to f7, rook to e1 attacking the queen, queen to d7, and now knight to e4, centralize the knight. This knight jump to g5 with check is really annoying. And so, for this reason, Caruana continues with king to g6, also for Stockfish, the best move. Knight to g5 comes the same, because this is a beautiful sort of outpost. And now, rook to d6. Queen to c3, attacking c5. Rook to c8, protecting the pawn, and now rook to e5. Here comes c4, the second rook moves to e1. Rook to d3, attacking the queen, and now queen to b4. Queen to b4 is good, but going back one move, queen to c2, pinning with an absolute pin, because there is the king on the same diagonal, blocking and pinning this rook is really terrible for black. Because with the rook that can't move, there is a beautiful knight maneuver that will win material. Now, let's, of course, this was not played by Dominguez Perez, also because with this complex position, the players are spending some time to play the moves. And let's remember that the format is 10 minutes plus 10 seconds per move, so a fast, rapid game. Now, let's play in this variation one of the best continuations for black, that is b5, and now let's watch this knight maneuver. Knight to e6 protected by the rook, there is this terrible knight jump that is a fork winning the exchange, so the king must move away. King to f7, king to h7 is the same thing because now there is knight captures on g7, the king cannot recapture, or rook to e7 will win the queen. After knight to e6, if the king, because there is only one king, moves to h6, again there is this knight capture. Now queen capture, queen to c1 comes with check, the king can't move to the 7th rank or the queen is lost, but king to g6. After this move, there is queen to g5 with check, black get checkmated, queen to h7, best idea, rook to e7, the queen is lost, and this is game over because white will give a simple checkmate. So, beautiful idea, this queen to c2, pinning the rook, not played by Dominguez Perez, that instead move the queen to queen to b4. Here comes b6, rook to e7 attacking the queen, queen to d6, of course, white that is attacking declines the queen's exchange, queen to a4, and now a5. Now, with all this annoying the queen moves back to c2, more or less there are the same threats that we watched before. Rook to c7 protecting the 7th rank is good, and now rook to e6 attacking the queen. Queen to f4, here comes g3, queen to f5, and there is a terrible threat. The threat is to win the queen with rook capture on g3 with check, and the queen will be lost because is unprotected. So Dominguez must move away the queen. Queen to e2, and now rook to d7. Rook captures on b6, another pawn is gone. Rook to d8, and now knight to e6, attacking the rook. Rook to d2, the queen must move away, but can't move too far, because behind the queen there is this terrible threat, queen capture with check that will give checkmate. So queen to e3, best idea, still defending f2. And now rook in 8 goes to d6. This is a terrible mistake in a very difficult position. Now this move allows knight to f8 with check, knight to f8 with check, king to f7, and now in this position white can win the rook. But Dominguez Perez only has 15 seconds on the clock, Caruana only 30 seconds, so from now on it's really a blitz game, and in a complex position like this one we will see some mistakes. Now, what is the tactical idea to win this rook? The combination begins with rook captures on d6. Now the rook must recapture, and with the rook that recaptures, the queen can give check because there is not anymore the threat of checkmate. Queen to e7 with check is also a fork. The queen recapture and also saves the knight. But in this position, after knight to f8 with check and king to f7, white goes directly for the king. Rook to b7 with check, the king can't capture the knight, because if king capture, there is queen to e7 with check, king to g8, queen captures on g7, checkmate. So after rook to b7, best idea is to use this knight as a protection, so king to g8, and now knight back to e6, the knight and the rook are attacking g7, king to h8 doesn't solve any problem, knight to g5, there is also this checkmate threat, so the king moves back to g8, and now another tactical idea that occurs with a few seconds on the clock, Dominguez Perez missed. Now queen capture on d2 is a fantastic tactical idea. After rook captures on d2, there is rook to b8 with check. And notice that this is already a four checkmate, because there is the back rank problem. Three pieces are watching the back rank, but all of them is watching a different square. So queen to c8, rook capture, rook to d8, rook captures, knight to e8, rook captures, checkmate. Let's go back to our game. Instead, after king to g8, here comes rook to b8 with check, rook back to d8, queen capture, the rook is pinned, but recaptures on b8, queen to d6 attacking the rook, and now the rook is passive on f8, and the white queen is very well positioned. Queen to d4, queen to c2, rook to e7 watching g7, queen to b1 with check, king to g2, queen back to f5, and now knight to e6. The knight, with the help of the rook, is attacking g7, but is also attacking this rook on f8. So Caruana, with some seconds on the clock, moves away the rook. Rook to e8, but this move loses on the spot, because here comes knight captures on g7, and black resigns. Let's watch the best continuation for black. Of course, black must save the queen. Queen to d5, we check. Will he change the queen? Seems the best idea in this terrible position. Queen capture, knight capture, but the rook is lost. The king captures this knight, but there is rook to e5. New material will be lost, and of course, this is a simple one endgame. A fun game played by Dominguez Perez, that now is up 1 point in the match against Caruana, but we know that with the clutch format, anything can happen. Of course, I will try to show you some of the best games, because it's impossible to tell you all the best games, because even with 2 videos per day, there are so many fun games to show you that it's not possible, but I will try to do my best. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and of course, we will meet soon with new games. Thanks for watching, and goodbye!